Hi, this is Sean D'Souza, and you're listening to the 3-Month Vacation Podcast. This podcast isn't some magic trick about how to work less. Instead, it's about how to really enjoy the work that you do and to enjoy your vacation time. Hi, it's Sean, and you're listening to the 3-Month Vacation. Back when I was about 20 or so, there was a neighbor of mine, Vernon, and Vernon wanted me to design a logo. And so I said yes. The only problem was that I had never designed a logo. But Vernon didn't care. In fact, I showed him a whole bunch of logos that, by the way, I was drawing on a piece of paper because back then, no one was really using computers. And Vernon looked at some of the logos and he picked one of them and he said, make this a lot better. And that's what I did. And he went ahead with the project. Now, Vernon was no kicking angel. Kicking angels are not like Vernon. They show a lot of interest in your project, whether it's a service or a product or an info product. And then when it's time to buy something, they're nowhere in sight. Their job is only to get you started. And this podcast is about kicking angels. Now, this is the first out of 6 reruns. And you know why we have these reruns, because it's time to take our vacation. This is the 3-month vacation podcast, after all. And we're off to Sweden, as you know, and then Denmark and Leiden, which is outside Amsterdam, and then finally to Singapore. So this one's about kicking angels, and you will enjoy it, especially because so many of our projects start out with someone so interested and then they back away. And their job is very specific. Instead of getting mad at the people who backed away, we should send them a thank you note. So here we go, kicking angels. In every podcast that you've listened to so far, it has been these 3 points that we cover, and then we get to what one thing you should do, and that's how a podcast rolls. But this time, I'm trying out something different, and we'll see how it goes. It's called the Psychotactics Short, and it's a very short one, but it's very pertinent. It's some of the articles that we've been writing since the year 2002, maybe 2000 even. And you probably never read them because they're lying in some archive. So I wanted to put them in a digital format. And what better place to put it than on the 3-Month Vacation podcast? This story that I'm about to tell you is one of the earliest lessons that I learned. It was a very important lesson because I didn't see it at the point in time. And it's called The Kicking Angel. You've heard of a guardian angel, haven't you? But what on earth is a kicking angel? Yes, it's exactly what it sounds like. It's an angel that does the job of giving you a swift kick on your rear. We started out with our first swift kick in the year 2002. We'd just set up Psychotactics and we were looking to sell our products on the internet. Did I say products? I meant product. But as most of us do, we were waiting. We'd been busy tweaking our website, we'd been searching for a merchant provider, and we'd been doing this for at least a month or two. We thought of setting up a sales page, and that went on for a whole 3 months. Then along came the kicking angel. This kicking angel happened to be an internet marketer. And yes, way back in 2002, that's when it all started, internet marketers. This internet marketer was kind of impressed with our first product, and he promised to help us, and he said that he would market it to his list. But here's what you have to do first, he said to us. I'll give you a week to set up everything. You'll need to set up a merchant account, you'll have to write your sales page, you'll have to set up the affiliate account, and then we'll start marketing your product in September. And your product will go to my list that has over 25,000 prospects. You know what we did next, don't you? Yes, in 1 week we did everything we'd been waffling about for well over a month. And then we went back to the internet marketer. And here's what he said. I'm a little busy doing promotions in September. How about October instead? October turned to November, November turned to December. Santa came and Santa went. Our internet marketer was always too busy, too preoccupied, too whatever. And we felt betrayed. We were angry. What we didn't realize was that the internet marketer wasn't a guardian angel after all. He'd got us moving. So as summer rolled along, we started selling our product. We sold 1-2 copies online. Now, remember, this was a measly 20-page booklet, which is the early version of the brain audit. But we were selling. And we were doing a jig around the room every time yet another product was sold. Amazingly, our kicking angel never came back. Ever. And that's when it dawned on us. A kicking angel isn't supposed to come back. That's what they're there for, to give you a kick. They kicked us into starting workshops, they kicked us into writing, into creating a series of products. They even came along and cajoled us into starting the Protégé program, which at that point was the most effective program. It helped me develop the article writing course, the info products course. All of these courses were put in place because of the Protégé program. And the person that pushed me into it, she never showed up. She didn't sign up. And here's the irony of it all. Kicking angels are classic ditchers. They promise to help, to promote, they promise to buy into the product, they promise to join a workshop. They swear to be there to sign on the dotted line, but they never, ever show up again. But in our desire to please those angels, we created products, we created services, we created courses and workshops, and our business grew. It took us a while to realize the role of the kicking angel. They weren't our friendly neighborhood volunteer. Not one of them turned out to be so much as a strategic alliance or customer. Their only job was to get us going. Their only job was to make us create stuff. And as a result, we danced. We danced a lot. We did that jig every time we got a sale. And that's what the kicking angel did for us. The kicking angel is not a guardian angel by a long shot. Their only job is to land that swift kick. And the funny thing is that they will keep at it until you listen. If your bum is sore from getting all those swift kicks, it's probably time. Time to listen to that kicking angel. Are you listening? This kicking angel phenomenon has occurred to us over and over again. Probably one of the most interesting examples of the kicking angel is the cartooning course. I didn't intend to start up a cartooning course. Psychotactics was about so many other things like pricing and marketing and strategy and all that stuff, but not cartooning. I mean, that was the world that I left behind. So when a client came in, and his name is Joe, and he suggested that we do the cartooning course, I was like, no, we're not doing the cartooning course. And Joe was very insistent. He was a member of 5000 BC, so he could be insistent in the forums and keep asking. And he said to me, look, I bought all these books. I've done courses before. I've done this stuff before. And I really want to learn how to draw cartoons. As an experiment, in 5000 BC, we started up the cartooning course. I had no intention of starting that course. I had no intention of running that course. In fact, because Joe was so insistent and he was being this kicking angel, I decided to have it in 5000 BC alone, just for the members. And we do this sometimes. We give stuff just for the members. So the entire course, absolutely free. And 30 people signed up for it. And that was the start of the cartooning course. Today, the cartooning course runs annually, and it's priced at close to $1,000. Joe put it on our agenda. But what happened to Joe? Well, Joe did sign up. It was free after all. And then Joe disappeared. And I've never heard from Joe again. Never again. I don't know where he is. That's what happens. That's what the kicking angel does. It forces you into a situation where you think, okay, I'll just do it because you're asking me to do it. And then it becomes part of your system, part of your revenue, part of who you are. I can't imagine the cartooning course going away from psychotactics today. In fact, it has spurred me to think of, say, maybe doing a cooking class or maybe even a photography course, because I do take good iPhone photographs, especially of food. If you've been on Facebook, you know what I'm talking about. And that's what this kicking angel has started, a whole bunch of things that I wouldn't have thought about. Now, obviously, you have the flip side, which is there are people that are asking you to do stuff all the time. What should you pay attention to? What should you not? And that is a matter of planning. And we've covered this in another podcast where you look at three things that you have to do. Those are the three things that you're going to do in a year. The podcast itself, the 3-month vacation podcast, was a result of a kicking angel. That person who pushed me, his name is Paul. He doesn't listen to this podcast, but for years he pushed me into it, and I emailed him and I thanked him for it, and he has no memory of it. And today this podcast has made such a big difference to us. The membership at 5000 BC has gone up. Now, remember, we've been in this business for a very long time. 5000 BC has existed as a membership site since 2003, so we know how many members join. We know how many sales we make with the brain audit and all of our products. Everything has gone up. The brain audit, the other products, 5000 BC membership, everything has gone up, and it's because of the podcast. And the kicking angel has gone. He wanted me to do the podcast. He doesn't listen to the podcast. And this is the whole point. So let's summarize what we've learned. The kicking angel comes along and pushes you into something. And if you decide to move on that something, you will find a whole new world that you hadn't anticipated. The second thing is that the kicking angel disappears after doing that task. They're not your guardian angel, they're a kicking angel. And finally, you've got to decide what you're going to do and what you're not going to do. And it's based on the Doug Hitchcock principle, which is you pick three things. And there is a podcast on this. Go and pick three things. And in 2014, we decided that we were going to pick the podcast, and it involved a lot of stuff. It involved equipment and recording and scripting and music and a lot of stuff. And that's what you have to do. So that's why you have to have three major projects in a year. What are you going to do next? It's very simple. Someone is probably kicking you already and you're not paying attention. Just pay attention. And that brings us to the end of this podcast. So what's happening in psychotactics land, or specifically what's happening in 5000 BC? Now, a long time ago, I used to go on vacation, and then you know how it is. You have this work momentum and you go into vacation land and you think, I'll just check email or I'll just sneak into 5000 BC and see what's happening. And because 5000 BC is so open, you can see when I've logged in. You can actually see my name showing up there that, you know, Sean's logged in. And I get emails from clients, from 5000 BC members saying, stay away, you're on vacation. This is what we're trying to do. We're trying to be like you. So stay away. And so now I have to stay away. And I have to say, it's nice to stay away. But what happens when we're not there? Lots of 5000 BC members have done courses with us, like the article writing course or the info products course. So they're very smart and they already run their own businesses. But there are also people that have just started out and they have ideas or they're starting to get ideas about how to run their own business. And this is where 5000 BC is really cool because people help each other, and especially when we're not around. So we have cave elves and they show up and these cave elves volunteer to help everyone or as many people as they can in 5000 BC. And so that's really what happens when we're not around. Now, a lot of people will say that they're on vacation. They will check email and do stuff like that. And we don't. And so we don't really know what is happening for pretty much that whole month. We're still on the internet. We still use the internet for maps and we use stuff like that. But everything else gets taken care of while we're away. That's the beauty of the 3-month vacation. And this is one of our months. But when we get back, there's still going to be a couple of home study versions of the courses. This is the article writing course and the info products course. So on the 21st of July, that's when we release the info products course. This is a home study, self-study version, and there are only going to be 35 copies. We are crazy. We do this for our home study versions where we only offer a limited amount, just 35. We're satisfied with that. So 21st of July, that's the info products course. And then the article writing course is on the 18th of September. That's when we will release it. So you have to get on the waiting list. Be sure to get on the waiting list. Go to psychotactics.com/xinfo for the info products course. And that'll get you right to the page where you can read all about it and get on the waiting list. Now, you know, I'm not in 5000 BC for the next month or so, but there is a 21-day wait when you get on the 5000 BC waiting list, which is another waiting list. So if you'd like to get there when I get back, then it's a good time to get on that waiting list, sign up to that waiting list, and when we get back, you will then be cleared to get into 5000 BC. So that's at 5000bc.com as always. And you can join us, and we have a pretty good time in 5000 BC. There's lots of information, but specifically, there is help. The elves and me, we're around to help. And of course, Renuka. Renuka is always there to look after you and, yes, to send you chocolate. And that's it from 5000 BC and psychotactics.com. Bye for now. Still listening? Today is probably June 24th or June 25th, which is exactly 6 months to Christmas. No, we're not doing any sale or any promotion here, but what happens in New Zealand is that people celebrate mid-winter Christmas because it's winter here and summer in your part of the world, probably. It depends where you are, but if you're in the Northern Hemisphere, it's summer. And what happened last year was Air New Zealand, which is the airline that we're very proud to fly on. They released a song with Ronan Keating. And here's how the song goes. It's a Christmas song, the New Zealand way. So yes, we're a little ahead of the Christmas schedule, but I think you'll enjoy the song. Here we go.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, Snow is glistening.
I'm going to stop you there, Roman.
Ronan.
It doesn't really snow down here at Christmas, yeah. Let's go with your bro is glistening.
Because a lot of people get sweaty down here. It's really sunny.
You want me to change the lyric?
Yep.
Okay.
Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? In the lane, your bro is glistening. A beautiful sight. We're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland.
Oh, hey, Roman. I'm not really feeling wintry. It's like 30 degrees outside. Let's go. Winter, minted, splinter. Oh, prickles.
Prickles.
Dodging heaps of prickles if you're Nan.
Okay, with the boss.
Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? In the lane, your bro is glistening. A beautiful sight. We're happy tonight. Dodging heaps of prickles with your Nan. Gone away is the bluebird.
They're more like greeny. It's more like a greeny brown bird.
And I was also thinking jandals.
Of course you were.
Like
popping the plug out of your jandals.
Sand in your togs. And pahutukawas.
Gone away is the greeny brown bird. Here to stay are the jandals.
Hold on, we're just gonna try
snoozing on a competitively priced Air New Zealand Sky Couch TM.
Right. Okay.
Roman, really?
Anyone here know how to sing?
Hey, Julian, man, I'm just not feeling it in there.
You know you can call me Jules.
Oh, you can call me Ronan.
Why? Is that like a nickname?
No, my name is Ronan.
Huh. Well, why don't we give it a go and we'll just see what happens?
Yeah, well, I had this, right, so.
Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? Sun bursting.
Icebox glistening, maybe?
I like that.
Icebox glistening. Beautiful sight.
Of Barbie's alive.
Of Barbie's alive. Strolling through a summer wonderland.
Summer wonderland.
Pour the salve in the sunshine.
Pavlova. So Pav.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Serve the Pav up at lunchtime.
Pop the bubbles for Nan.
Pineapples on ham. Strolling through a summer wonderland. In the arbor we can grab the wickets.
As you do.
The plastic cricket bat your brother found.
Yeah, right.
Backyard full of all your distant rallies.
So we pass the can of Mozzie spray around.
Later on, sun is falling.
Your drunk uncle, yeah, he's snoring.
We'll hear the birds in the trees.
And the warm summer breeze.
Strolling through a summer wonderland. Way down here, Christmas landmarks. Summer flowers.
And finally Denmark's.
We're happy and bright, not a snowman in sight. Strolling through a summer wonderland.
Ronan, we got it.
Jules, we have it. Merry Christmas, dude.
Oh, Merry Christmas, thank you.
Hey, do you guys need some sunblock?
Oh, yeah, Ronan might need
it. Yeah, it's 50 enough.
No, you'll probably need 70.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? Sunburns sting, icebox glistening. The beautiful sight of Barbie's alight. Strolling through a summer wonderland. Pour the salve in the sunshine. Serve the Pav up at lunchtime. Pop the bubbles for Nan, pineapples on ham. Strolling through a summer wonderland. In the arbor we can grab the wickets. And plastic cricket bat your brother found. Backyard full of all your distant relatives. So we pass the can of Mozzie spray around. Later on, sun is falling. And your drunk uncle snoring. 10 months. We're happy and bright, not a snowman in sight. Strolling through a summer, strolling through a summer, strolling through a summer wonderland.
Well, how did you like that? If you find yourself humming Christmas songs through the day and people think you're crazy, well, tell them it was because of Psycho Tactics. That's why we call Psycho. I'll say bye for now. Bye-bye.